Hi, and welcome back to myexcelonline.com. This week, we are going to be talking about data validation. How do you put data inside of an Excel spreadsheet and check that data before allowing the cell to be updated? So some examples of doing this would be validating a field for whether or not it's a valid date, how many decimal places it has, what kind of number formatting you would like, whether or not it's greater than or less than a certain value. Data validation is just a good way to trap for errors to ensure more data integrity inside your Excel spreadsheet. This week, I've created a spreadsheet that is going to track our ice cream production in our family-run ice cream production company. So what I would like to do here is put in the date and then the line that the ice cream was produced on, and then the product that was produced on that line, and the amount of boxes or containers that were produced on that line today. So let's think through some of the data validation that we would like in this. In column B, we are going to want this to be a legitimate date. In column C, this is the line that we are doing production on, so we are going to want this to follow our naming convention for the lines that we have in our production plant. So for here, we want lines that are only two characters long. For the product, we are going to choose from only a predefined list of products that we manufacture in our plant. And for the amount, this should be between 1 and 100 because it is not possible for us to produce over 100 containers of a single product in a single day. So let's start here with column B, with the date. How do I ensure that a date is entered in this column? Well, first, I'm going to highlight the column for date, and I'm going to go on the data tab, and then I'm going to go to this icon right here for data validation. Hit the down arrow and select data validation. Under this first box, I'm going to select the down arrow and pick date. And I have several options for this date. So what I would like for this date is just for it to be greater than or equal to today. So for my start date, I'm going to type equals today with a left parenthesis and a right parenthesis. And then I'm going to say okay. So let's test my data validation. If I go to cell B3 and I type in 6/30 and hit enter, it accepted my date for today because today is June 30th, 2021. But let's try yesterday. That would be 6/29, and I'm going to hit enter. And now I'm getting an error message. We will come back to this error message and how you can customize that a little bit later. But for now, I'm going to hit cancel. And let's try tomorrow, 7/1, and hit enter. So as you can see, the data validation is working here for all dates that are greater than or equal to today. So we have now successfully validated column one. Now, how about this next column, the production line? Remember that I said that the production line can only be two characters long. So let's highlight all of the cells that we wish to validate here, most of column C in our table, and go back up to the data validation, select data validation, and this time we're going to allow a text length. And we really want this to be a text length equal to 2. We don't want any more than 2 characters or any less than 2 characters. So if I click OK and I go over here to my line, this was manufactured on line A1. As you can see, that is correct. But what would happen if I went up here and I typed A11 and hit enter? Again, you will see I'm being returned with an error message. What if I just clicked in here and typed A and hit enter? I'm also returned with an error message because in the first case, I was typing in 3 characters, and in this case, I am typing in 1 character. So I'm going to hit cancel. How about for the product? Over here on this tab called products, I have a list of all the products that we manufacture in our manufacturing company. I could have also created a list here with all of the manufacturing lines, but because I want to show you different ways of doing some data validation, I didn't do that for this tutorial, but that is certainly something that I would recommend doing. So in this case, I want to go back to production and I want to highlight everything in column D and go up to data validation. And this time under allow, I'm going to pick list. And I want these values to be limited to a list somewhere on my spreadsheet. So under here where it says source, I'm going to click this up arrow and then I'm going to click on my products tab and I'm going to just highlight all of my products and hit enter. And then when I come back to the screen, I'm going to click OK. So now when I click in the product cell, I can see this down arrow. When I click the down arrow, I can see my options. And if I type anything in here besides my options, and hit enter. Again, I'm returned with the error message that we will contend with in a few minutes. So I'm just going to hit cancel. Now I'm going to go to the amount field and I'm going to highlight the amount column, go up to data validation and allow a whole number because I'm not going to create half a box of anything. And I want that to be between 1 and 100. So my minimum is 1, my maximum is 100 and my data is between and I'm going to click OK. So here, if I type a 0, I will be returned with an error that I will cancel out of. But if I type a 1, it's working. If I type 101, I am receiving another error. But if I type just 100, I do not receive an error. So this is functioning the way that I was hoping that it would. I did want to show you again in the number validation, you do have some options and it's the same thing with the date. Your options include between, not between, equal to, not equal to, greater than, less than, or greater than or equal to, and less than or equal to. So you have most comparisons covered in this list. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. What I would like to do again is highlight column B where I have date fields going in and go back up to my data validation. And I would like to click on input message. And right here, show an input message when cell is selected. I can type in a title here, please enter a date. And the message that I would like to display here would be dates are the only data type for this field. And I'm going to click OK. So as you can see, when I type in this field, I get a box that says, please enter a date. This will notify the user that only a date can be entered in this type of field. But if I click over online, notice that pop-up box isn't working yet because I have not programmed it to do so. I'm going to highlight column E, click the down arrow and go to data validation. And what kind of error do we want to display when the user enters invalid information? So we as the programmer have put in what the data validation rules are, but this is often not communicated to the user. So what we could do is we can pick a different style, whether it is stop with an X, warning with an exclamation point, or information with an I. In this case, because the data is incorrect, I would pick the stop option. Over here for the title, I would put invalid data. And the error message should say, please enter only values between 1 and 100. Just so the user knows what kind of data is allowed in this cell. And then I can click OK. So now, upon error, if I were to type 0 and hit enter, now I'm returned with the custom error message that I have set up, and I'm going to type cancel. You can do this kind of validation on other cells as well. So you have a lot of flexibility with the information that you can communicate to your users. If you want to get rid of all of this data validation, you can highlight all of your cells, click the down arrow, click data validation, and right here I will have a warning message that says, do I want to erase my current settings and continue? If I say okay, I will lose everything that I just put in. So for now, I'm going to say cancel. And the reason that this comes up is because I have selected all of my data validation columns. So let's hit cancel. If I only select one of my validation columns, say it, let's say column B, and I go back to data validation, I was not asked if I want to clear all values because this column has the same data validation for every cell. But in here, if I no longer want this data validation, I can click this button here that says clear all and then say OK. And now when I go over to my dates, I can type anything in. It does not even need to be a date. Or I can type a date in that is yesterday and less than my rule. So in summary, we went over the data validation option by going to the data tab and typing this icon over here and going to data validation. There are several options on the data validation. First of all, you have options of what kind of numbers or dates or length of your text string. You can customize an input message when the user hovers over the cell so that they know that this is a cell that requires some kind of data validation. Or you can go to the error alert and instead of having the pop-up happen all the time, just display a message when the user enters invalid data. You can use the clear all button to clear all validations that you have pre-programmed into this selection of cells. Hopefully you learned more about data validation than you knew before we started this video. Thank you for watching and hopefully we'll see you again next week.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.